there you got to look at hip hop as being on the whole where it came from. You know, hip hop is like a Frankenstein monster in terms of genres. Hip hop is like a Frankenstein monster. You know, it borrows so much from a lot of different genres, right? So dia ada daripada, obviously daripada benda-benda macam dancehall, reggae, you know, the sound system culture, you know, they took Latin music, you know, like boogaloo, you know, boogaloo is a sub-genre, they took from jazz, they took from funk, you know, so from the start, it's always, it's made, it's rojak.
Yes.
From the start, it's rojak. So for if from the start is like that, it's easier to put in, yeah, to inject other DNAs.
Yes.
You know, so you see it happening. You see them doing it with various genres of Asian music, various forms of Asian music. You see them doing it with classical, with rock. You know, it's done. So it's there. So from the start, kita punya source material tu, not source material lah. Kita punya starting point, starting genre tu is already very adaptable.
Right.
You know, and that's why it is led to one of the factors why it's a global phenomenon now is that,
okay,
right? And there's another reason why hip hop music has such an influence on pop music. You look at hip hop source material, right? This at the start of it, right? And how sampling comes into play,
yeah,
right? You had a bunch of creative kids who wanted to express themselves, who wanted to make music, but they cannot, they don't have the instruments. Their parents cannot afford instruments. They cannot afford music class. So what did they do? They made, like necessity is the mother of invention.
Yeah.
They took what is around them and, you know, they turned a music player into a music instrument, a record,
yes,
player.
Right? Yeah.
So what else, what other sources, what other materials they have around them? They had their parents' new record collection, right? And that's what they used to make music. And that's why hip hop got a lot of funk, jazz,
yes,
disco, and all that. You unlearn creating in one language to relearn creating in another language,
yeah,
or creating it on in another paradigm,
because
that's what hip hop is,
right?
There are a bunch of kids who did not know, or did not want to sing. Right, so they vocalize in a more rhythmic fashion,
right,
as opposed to more melodic,
right?
Right, so they had to unlearn one thing and learn something else. So it's the same thing. I think when you're expressing yourself, it's always important to incorporate your identity into your work, you know. So it will depend on, you know, there are factors, you know, there are factors that you can attribute to your social identity, your physical, I'm seeing geophysical location,
yes,
and racial and economic, you know, factors that come into play lah. So
yeah,
I think it is important.
Yeah.
I think it's important because we are in the business of creating something out of expressing ourselves.
Yeah.
Right? And it's more important for hip hop because hip hop is very personal.
Right.
You know, hip hop ni they are singer songwriters.
Yes.
You know, if you think about it lah.
Especially,
yes. You know, so what is the one of the big KPIs? One of the big things, points that's important for singer songwriters has always been sincerity in your craft.
Yes.
You know, you talk about yourself.
Yeah.
You know, you talk about what you're going to. You know, yeah, it's all the hallmarks of rappers
.
You know, and making hip hop music, you just got to express yourself and be true to yourself. So yeah, it's important. I don't think it's lacking, but maybe it doesn't get as much attention as it should, right? But for hip hop, like Chuck D, I started listening to hip hop, Public Enemy. Like Chuck D said, rap is ghetto, the ghetto CNN.
Yes.
So okay. You report, you talk about the things around you. Right, you always talk about the things around you. That's why, for me, when one big moment of clarity was hip hop is lagu rakyat.
Yeah.
Right. But when you think about lagu rakyat in Malaysia, you think Nora Zainal is this.
Mm-hmm.
You think City. You think Cindai.
Yeah.
Right. So, in order to refine the idea even more, is lagu rakyat kota raya. you know, urban folk music, because that's what it is in the States, that's what it is here.
Yes.
You know, so that's what you talk about, bro. Mm-hmm. You know, that's why based on my theory that hip hop is lagu rakyat kota raya, Malaysia's first hip hop artist is Allahyarham Sudirman.
Yes.
Because dia yang buat lagu Gadis Kilang, lagu Balik Kampung, lagu Punch Card, you know, kan? That is lagu rakyat kota raya, lagu rakyat, you know. And if you nak buat lagu rakyat, you kena tengok apa you buat that rakyat go through. There's a reason why 50 Cent rap about drugs and guns.
Yes.
You know, because that's what his people is going through. That's what he sees on a daily basis at that time.
Yeah.
Right? And then now it's different lah. You know, you got to talk about different things. Right? Look at what Jay-Z used to talk about early on.
Yeah.
And now he's talking about his raps about venture capitalism.
Right.
Because that's what surrounds him now. He raps about his kids because that's what surrounds him now. So it's the same thing here. If that is what is around you and you feel that you want to speak about it, you want to speak on it, you want to speak to or on the behalf of certain people, the people around you, then go for it. Rap music first became popular and, you know, the people who didn't like it, you know, attacked it from a cultural standpoint whereby this is not our culture. You guys listening to this, you guys are forgetting about your traditional culture, your traditional values, and this and that, you know. But you see, I cannot, but what I saw was different because my role models look up to their culture, to their heritage.
Yes.
So the people that taught me to go and study about Zapin, study about Joget, study about Inang, kan, is because of hip hop.
Yes.